In this lecture, I will explain you about pipelining. One of the approach to increase the efficiency of conventional microprocessor or digital signal processor is instruction cycle pipelining. Instruction cycle in general consists of four phases, that is instruction fetch phase, decode phase, read phase and execute phase. These four phases are implemented as four independent units in hardware, and each unit will take equal amount of time. Now I will explain you about a processor which is non-pipelined. Figure 1 shows instruction cycle of non-pipelined processor. Here the first column represents the time. In the first clock pulse, only instruction L1 is fetched. During this time, these decode unit, read unit and execute unit, these three are idle. In the second clock cycle, instruction L1 enters decode phase. During this time, fetch, read and execute are idle. In the third clock pulse, instruction L1 enters read phase. In the fourth clock pulse, instruction L1 enters execute phase. During this time, fetch, decode and read are idle. After 4 clock pulses, only instruction L1 is executed. After another 4 clock pulses, instruction L2 is executed. And after another 4 clock pulses, instruction L3 is executed. We can observe that only one unit is active at any given point of time. Now, I will explain you about a pipeline processor. Figure 2 shows the pipeline processor. Here, in the first clock pulse, instruction L1 is fetched. In the second clock pulse, instruction L1 enters decode, whereas L2 instruction is fetched. In the third clock pulse, instruction L1 enters read phase, instruction L2 enters decode phase, instruction L3 is fetched. In the fourth clock pulse, instruction L1 is executed, instruction L2 is read, instruction L3 enters decode, instruction L4 is fetched. After 4 clock pulses, the first instruction L1 is executed. After every clock pulse, next instructions are executed. In 5th clock pulse, L2. In 6th clock pulse, L3. In pipeline processor, and now we will compare the pipeline processor with the non-pipeline processor. Here the total time is 12 units. In 12 units of time, only 3 instructions are executed. In the same 12 units of clock pulses, in a pipeline processor, 9 instructions are executed. That is 3 into 3. That is, the throughput with the pipelining is improved by 3 times. That is, the efficiency of the pipeline processor is improved by 3 times. Apart from improvement in efficiency, the pipeline processor has got 2 limitations or 2 drawbacks. The first one is it has got latency. That is, the first instruction is executed after 4 units of time. That is, if an instruction cycle consists of 4 phases, then after 4 clock pulses, first instruction will be executed. The second drawback is, if one instruction, say L6, is a conditional jump instruction, then the instructions that are in read phase, decode phase and fetch phase are to be saved into the memory, and then the jump instruction, where it points, those location, that instructions are to be fetched. These two are the drawbacks of the pipelined processor. This completes the explanation of pipelining.